So when the evil shadow monster in the woods wakes again to feast on the joy of our townspeople, beware! For his next victim could be you! And thus concludes my report on the history of our great town.
Be quiet, all of you! And as for you, see me after class. How did you find out about the joy-sucking shadow monster in the woods?
What? I just made that stuff up.
Tell me the truth now, or you're in trouble.
But Miss Me, the whole thing was just a silly story. Pinky swear.
Oh, but of course it was. Forget everything I said. You can go home.
Yes! Wait, why are you acting so weird? Is there really a monster?
If you won't go home, I will!
Okay, no, the left leg! The left!
Oh no, are we being robbed? I surrender!
At ease, Ben. We're practicing to win the three-legged race at the carnival's Jamboree of Joy.
Tom, let's try three-legged leaps!
Wow! Look what came in the mail! Our official joyware!
How exciting! I can't wait to see Ginger's smile when he first lays eyes on the churro juggler!
Speaking of Ginger, where is he?
Tonight's monster hunt.
A monster hunt?
It has been 100 years since the monster last woke, so tonight he will be eager to feast on the joy of innocent, happy townspeople.
What was that? Is somebody there?
Why'd they let you be a monster hunter? You're old and boring!
Quiet!
I should be the one on the monster hunt. You have to take me, or everybody at school sees this!
It has been 100 years since the monster last woke.
Now the only thing they'll see is you in detention.
The video's already backed up to the cloud.
They made a video cloud? No fair. Oh, you can come. But you can't tell a soul about this. Pinky swear it.
Yes! Pinky swear it! I can't believe I'm gonna see my first monster! I'm so excited, I feel like I'm gonna explode!
Calm down. This hunt is about patience and discipline.
Ugh, this is so boring. How did you make monster hunting boring?
If you're having such a terrible time, you're welcome to go home. It's close. It's time for us to keep waiting, but more quietly.
That is it! Your way of monster hunting is ridiculous!
Ginger, no!
No fair, Miss Vanthrax!
you tiny fool! I needed to capture the monster, but you forced me to scare it away! You ruined my hunt!
I'm sorry. I didn't realize a monster would be so scary!
No. No, no. There's no need for big emotions. Let's think about this. The monster will go to whatever part of town is the happiest. Maybe a fabric store or a dentist. The waiting room at a bank.
Wait, the happiest place. I think I know where that is!
I can't believe you guys walked all the way to the jamboree like that.
Well, Ginger might not be here, but I still want to win that race.
Guys, they have jawbreakers the size of a soccer ball! Oh, our young friend doesn't know what he's missing. Well, you need to be a more supportive friend, you big jerk!
Hey!
Move your butt, Angela.
Move your butt! Or should I say your face? You're a butt face! Yeah.
The monster is turning the jamboree of joy into a jamboree of jerks!
It's too late. I failed my mission.
No, I failed your mission, but I'll make this right. There has to be something we can do!
I can trap the monster in this orb, but I need to lure it to me. And I can't lure it when it's already in a buffet of happiness in there.
So someone has to be bait! All we need to do is lure the monster into a corner and set a trap! I'll do it, Miss V! I'll make you proud!
Stop! It's way too dangerous for you!
I know it's dangerous, but we need joy. And I'm a little boy at a carnival full of candy up past my bedtime. I can bring the joy! They can do this! He's not that scary. You call yourself a joy sucker?
My students, but me!
I don't care.
Tom, I am so sorry I said all those terrible things about your face.
It must have been all this racing stress. I never meant for this to come between us.
Oh, Tom, nothing can come between us.
Let's win this!
Are you all right? Speak to me.
Coming here was... mistake.
A mistake for the monster! I totally tricked it! And then you swooped in, you were like, pow, 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 pow!
I know, Ginger. I was there. But yes, the two of us working together was pretty neat, as I'm told you kids say.
Those were some incredible monster-smashing moves, Miss Vanthrax. I guess you're not so boring after all, even if you are old.
Yes, you demonstrated bravery and smarts.
Ginger? I thought you were studying for a big test.
Yeah. The truth is that Ginger finished studying early.
Do you want to see a jawbreaker the size of a soccer ball?
Of course I do! Why would you even ask me something like that?
Oh, it's fine. Go be with your friends. You earned it. Oh, don't stay out too late. You still owe me a real history report tomorrow.
Who's ready for family game night?
Oh, yeah!
I love family game night! All of you are going down.
Ooh, what do we play this time? Sugar City. Oh, no, a medical procedure. Ooh, apologize.
Easy, Hank. Before we pick a game, we have to pick who picks the game using the Wheel of Choosing.
Yeah, I called up some spinning. Super complicated, impossible nerd games that nobody understands.
Worry not, my friends. This time I've got something new. A mysterious game I found in an old curio shop. The cashier said it just appeared on a shelf one day. Then he cackled, which I take to mean that the game is a lot of fun. It's called Welcome to the Dungeon.
I don't know, Ben. Are you sure we won't need graph paper for this?
Relax! I know I've made picks that you didn't love before, but this game is gonna be completely different!
Ben, what did you do?
I didn't do anything.
Oh, no. I think we're in the game.
Well, that's just preposterous.
You're welcome to the dungeon. The game where you must survive a perilous world and defeat the Diamond Dust Dragon. For 2 to 6 players.
Who's preposterous now, Ben?
Hold on. We were just supposed to play a board game. But now, you're saying that we have to go on some fantasy adventure and fight a dragon? I mean, that sounds amazing!
Yeah! Ultimate family game night!
How's the game go, Dungeon Dude?
First, you must choose your character card.
Neat! I'm a noble knight.
An archer thief, this fits.
A wizard! Your wish is my command.
A fearsome barbarian. Nice!
You guys look great, but get ready for me because I'm the sheltered princess.
Nice dress, m'lady. Whoa!
Okay, wow.
Now I will explain the rules.
We can figure it out as we go along. Let's just start playing, right, guys?
Very well. Enjoy your game.
He's laughing, I'm laughing, we're having fun. Oh, this is gonna be great.
Welcome to the dungeon! Please turn in any amulets of power that you might have collected on your journey.
What is an amulet?
Did anyone manage to find the three crystals of color? The leather of leveling up? The pickle of power?
What are you talking about? We didn't know about any of that.
I see. Well, this is going to hurt.
Oh, wow. We're not dragon fried. But we're back at the start of the game. What happened?
You were defeated by the Diamond Dust Dragon. Sorry about that.
But that's okay. We'll get him next time. See you on the next game night, Stone Guy. How do we get out of here?
You simply have to beat the dragon. And unless you do, you're trapped forever!
Ben, you are never allowed to pick a game ever again.
What? There's no way I could have known about this.
Sure there is. It's all explained in the official game rule.
Inventory management? Character statistics? Upgrade tokens? Oh, I should have known. This is one of Ben's super complicated, impossible nerd games that no one understands.
Okay. I heard about Welcome to the Dungeon. It's a legendary nerd game no one ever beat. I thought that was because no one was up to the challenge.
No. It's because everyone who ever played got trapped inside.
How could you do this to me?
Yeah, what were you thinking?
Great game, Ben.
No way,
everybody
Ben.
Calm down. I can defeat the dragon for you, okay? I'm good at games like this. I like them. So you just sit back and let me fix everything.
What did you do?
He broke a major rule of Welcome to the Dungeon. This game is for 2 to 6 players, not one player. If you break a major rule, you become a cave crab. It happens to everyone, eventually.
What are we gonna do? No one's as good at games as Ben.
Hey, guys, I ordered a bucket of sludge 3 days ago. It says it was delivered, but I didn't... Oh, hello, where is everybody? Oh, this must be one of them family game nights I've heard about. Ben? Ginger? Hello? Oh, maybe there. Oh!
Huh? Oh, no. Jeremy, you too?
Huh? Where am I?
We're trapped in a game, and the only way out is to beat it. And the rules are really confusing.
Also, Ben is a crab now.
No! Trapped? Trapped? No, I can't be trapped. A germ needs space to spread.
Then help us figure out the difference between backup mana and reserve magic. Except you can't, because this whole stupid thing is impossible!
Well, if I had to guess, I'd say backup mana lets you cast more spells, and reserve magic lets you cast bigger spells, maybe?
Yeah, that kinda almost makes sense.
Yeah, I'm good at rules. I had to learn the rules of the big people world, even the crazy ones like toilet flushing. Have a plan.
Welcome back. Are you ready for a rematch? Reveal your amulets, crystals, and pickles of power.
Yeah, we don't have any of that, but we have something better. A good understanding of this game's rules.
Ha! No one understands this game. That's why it's so challenging. Prepare for your dragony doom.
Wait! Pause! Rule violation! The dragon cannot roar and slam its tail in one turn. That is considered 2 separate actions.
Good point. Dragon, do it right.
Rule violation. condition, you can't attack the sheltered princess yet because of all the shelter.
Yeah, all right, fine.
Rule violation, I cast lightning at level 3.
Rule violation, a diamond dust
rule
dragon.
Rule violation, can't dodge me.
Rule violation.
Enough of this! You're making this not fun! Dragon Blaster!
Rule violation!
What? What now?
This is a game where you fight a dragon, not a dragon and a dungeon defender.
So this is a rule violation of one of the major rules of this game.
You know what happens to people who break the major rules?
No! I hate when I don't win! I don't want to play anymore!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, we did it!
What did you mean?
What happened? Did I save everyone with my knightly prowess?
Not at all, Ben.
It wasn't impossible. All it took was some thinking and memorization.
Yeah, I almost had a good time. Almost.
Well, that's nice to hear. Because I'm still in charge of Family Game Night! And I have a few more games I want to try.
I have got a bad feeling about this.
Oh, seriously, Tom? I'm about to do a concert next to an ancient desert pyramid. What could possibly be bad about it?
How about how this was set up by Ricky DeLuna? He does not like you.
Yeah, he acted like a jerk. But now he wants to apologize. I'm not gonna not accept an apology, Tom. That's just not me.
Plus, he gave us these awesome gift baskets. And, ooh, there's gumballs in these.
Dip on a green one!
No, too slow!
Whoops! Yo, Angela! Check out this sweet stage slide for the show. This concert's gonna be beyond gravity.
Yeah, it is.
Wait, the MC is MCing this? But you had that very public fight with Ricky, remember?
And now for our main musical event! Give it up for Ricky DeLuna, a.k.a. Slicky! He told me not to give him a nickname, but I'm doing it, y'all! Slicky! 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 Turns out the dude really hates nicknames. But now he's obviously trying to patch things up between us.
Well, it's Angela and the MC, my least favorite performers. You better do a good show tonight, because my thumb is ready to down.
What, music critic Victoria Payne? You said Ricky's last album sounded like rocks in a blender. Now, am I the only one here who thinks it's just a little bit weird that Ricky put together a concert with all of his enemies?
Relax, Tom. Ricky is trying to change, and he's doing it with an all-star concert blowout.
Oh, no! The MC is gone!
And so are my gumballs. Who did this?
MCs don't just disappear. There must be something going on here, and I'm gonna...
Yeah, there is! Check this out! Welcome to the Desert Tomb Concert Hall, home to rocking music and shocking mummy curses.
Mummy curse? That's so scary I can't even react to it with a real word. I have to make one up. Zogs? No. Zorks? No. Zooks?
This is all the evidence I need. The MC was taken by a mummy, which means we're gonna have to fight a mummy! I'll lead the way!
Easy, Ginger. I'm sure there's a logical explanation for this that doesn't include mythical baddies.
Yeah, especially when there's a not-mythical baddie right here. Ricky, show yourself, you creep! You can't hide, Ricky. We know you stole the MC.
Oh, Tom, thank goodness. I thought you were
The mummy.
Whew, sorry, I tripped over this large drum.
Okay, Ricky, cut the act, will ya? We know you're behind this. You invited all of your musical enemies to the desert so you could get rid of them.
No, you must believe me. I didn't think the mummy was real either. But then I found that on my mirror.
That's definitely an ancient mummy symbol.
Yes, I hoped it was a drawing made by one of my beautiful fans. But now I know it was a warning about the curse of the mummy.
Whoops! Sorry.
Protect me. I only wanted to do a concert to apologize for being such a big jerk. I wouldn't have done it if I knew this place had a monster.
Ricky, surely you know you're talking about a silly made-up...
Jeepers! Ricky DeLuna is gone. And something left mummy rags.
I'm officially creeped out now. Oh, could it be that Ricky was telling the truth?
Let's be logical. There's someone here who disliked both the MC and Ricky.
Then it wasn't me.
I'm talking about Victoria Payne.
If Victoria is up to something, we have to find out what. Let's split up, gang.
Yeah, yeah. Everything is getting dealt with. Soon, this will all be over.
That sounds suspicious. What is she talking about?
Is this a clue I smell? No, it was something else.
No sign of Victoria.
But I do see more of those gift baskets Ricky was giving out. There might be gumballs in them.
Ginger, will you take this seriously? We have a mystery to solve.
Well, that went nowhere. Though I did find an extra bathroom.
Look at this! It's just like the symbol in Ricky's room!
This must be a clue! Everyone, be careful. We don't want to set off any traps.
Shoo!
I think you set off a trap, Tom.
Why would there be a rake in here? That doesn't fit the ancient desert tomb theme.
Ben, who cares about a dumb rake? We've landed in the mummy's chamber. Maybe this is where Ricky and the MC went. Are you here? Call out yes if you are, and no if you're not.
Calm down. That sound is merely air passing through tiny cracks in the pyramid's ancient stone wall.
You believe in pyramid air all you want, but I know a ghoul when I hear one. That was definitely a ghoul. Let's do this! Everybody punch his ancient face!
Zoinks! The mummy is real!
Oh, zoinks! That's the word I was looking for.
Quick! Into those dark tunnels!
I told you it was a mummy. I would have beat it, but I wanted to protect you. You know how I am.
Yeah, sure, Ginger.
But if it's really a mummy, then who was Victoria suspiciously calling on the phone?
I was calling my driver so I could get out of here. No concert review is worth a curse, no matter how quotable my quips may be. Later.
And the mummy got her.
This isn't fair! The joy of hundreds of music lovers is being messed up by one lousy monster!
I knew this concert was bad news. Let's get out of here!
Way ahead of you, pal. Later!
Don't you guys know anything? The mummy already saw us. No matter where we go, it'll follow and get us! Everybody knows that about mummies!
Sure! Everyone knows that! Mummies are real! Up is down! Science is fiction!
If we can't run, then we have to fight. We'll come up with a plan to put this mummy back in its tomb.
Oh, thanks.
You know that I like you. Cause when it's me and you, dreams come true.
Hey, real Angela, you did a great job making mop, Angela.
Thanks. Now we should give Hank a sign when the mummy attacks.
Like the one you just gave me?
What are you talking about?
Isn't that why you tapped me on the shoulder? To make me do that?
I didn't tap you, Tom.
Guys, get the rope!
Yes! Hey, Mummy! Check me out over here! All not cursed!
Angela, what are you doing? Run!
No, Tom! I'm not gonna let some rad-brained bully ruin my show!
Double Zoid! He's unraveling!
Close your eyes! Ricky DeLuna?
Ricky DeLuna? I was right all along. This whole concert was a trap so you could use a mummy curse to get rid of your music enemies. You drew that mummy symbol on your mirror. You used the rake to erase your footprints, and you pretended to be scared so he wouldn't suspect you.
It was a perfect plan, and I would have gotten away with it too if it weren't for you meddling people who I specifically invited here.
Hey, Ricky, you're getting my worst review yet. 12 thumbs down. A little help, guys?
Come on, that's harsh.
Later, Slicky. I think you'll need this to cool off that mad burn.
Right, the concert. With all this mummy madness, I almost forgot I had to do a show.
You've got this, Angela. Now go make those people scream. But, you know, happy screams, not the terrified ones.
You know that I like you. So let's hang out together.
We saved everything.
Indeed. Plus, we proved that there's definitely, absolutely, positively no such thing as...
Sorry. Boy, am I Mr. Clumsy today.